79 overall is not too great, and then a lot of great, or at least good, bench players. So, with that being said, I think I'm just going to be simulating this season and hopefully getting something in free agency, making some trades happen, but this is going to definitely be one of the hardest rebuilds to do, because I don't think I've ever even done a Pacers rebuild before, at least a successful one. They're definitely one of the harder teams to rebuild, because they're in such a they're not amazing like a championship contending team, but they're also not a bottom feeding team, so it's kind of hard to see what happens. So let's just hope for the best, I guess, and I will see you guys when I guess the playoffs start, and hopefully we get some a good matchup. And we are back. So it is the start of the playoffs. The Blazers actually made the playoffs in this simulation. That's been happening a lot more for me recently. Nothing too crazy, it seems like. Orlando, we are going up against the Miami Heat, and it looks like Philadelphia fell all the way down to the 6th seed. That's pretty depressing. Oh, one thing I do need to do is make Kevin Durant injured still. And I think that's the only major player in the playoffs that's hurt. So let me do that right now, actually. Okay, now that is done. So we are going up against Miami, who probably are going to be starting. Oh wow, the FJ Crouch starting. Okay, that's interesting. They'll have Tyler Herro, Duncan Robinson. This year I'm not going to be too focused on trying to win a championship, obviously, because we have to go against Milwaukee, and they're always a crazy matchup to try to go up against. So I think I'm just going to simulate a couple games to see what we do. I at least want to get out of the first round, so let's see what happens. Please don't lose this next game. Wow, we are really about to get swept. Okay, well, I guess I should show you guys first that, yeah, it's on the 50 simulator. Let's go over to a game plan for the Heat, Miami Heat. Wow, they want DJ Warren come off the bench. Okay, I'm not gonna do that. We do need to give Sabonis some more minutes. That's for dang sure. Let's do that. Oh my god, we're running an 11-man rotation. Nate McMillan, you freaking idiot. Why would you ever do that? An 11-man. Well, I guess we have a lot of players who could play, I guess. But no, I guess I'll put Dougie here. Get more minutes to DJ McConnell. Jimmy Lamb obviously needs to be the 6th man. Sorry, buddy. Actually, we're gonna get Goga back up center spot position. Okay, this is fine. It's fine. Going to tightly guard, because I know they get some major shooters on that team. And then I really just want, I guess, Victor Oladipo is a really good defending guard. So I guess we can have Oladipo on Jimmy Butler. That might be our best bet. And then we can have Brogdon on Dragic to try to stop him, because I know he's also a great scorer. Oladipo, and then Malcolm Brogdon. Okay, it's not bad. Bench depth, 9. Short on the plays, a little more of that. Well, that's fine. Do about 65. Pacers playbook. Does anything. Okay, wow, we got freaking swept. Alright, so not the greatest first season I've done, but again, this is not for the championship this season. No offense to any Pacers fans out there, which I'm very surprised there's a little bit of a handful of people wanting me to do the Pacers rebuild for a little bit, but oh my god, the Bucks. Wow. The Bucks got upset, and Clippers got upset as well. Denver's going on a winning spree. Oh my god. Wow, the Denver Nuggets and the Heat. Yo, wow. The Denver Nuggets upset not only the Clippers, but also the LA Lakers. That is insane. Wow, that's one of the craziest simulations I've seen. That's crazy. Alright, well, I guess we can go to the draft. loss. That kind of sucks. Oh well. The Bulls get the full first pick. I'm going to do the staff signing, and then I'll see you guys at the draft, because yes, I'm going to be doing a little bit of shaking up to this roster. It definitely needs it. Alrighty, we are on to the NBA draft, which hopefully isn't anything too crazy. I don't think I want to make any huge shakeups. I want to test the market for Brogdon. Actually, I might be fine with him being our starting point guard. It's actually not that bad. He's averaging 15 points per game, 7 assists. He's a good defender as well. He just needs to up his 3-point percentage, which I might put him in a 3-point training camp. I think I'm going to do that actually this offseason. DJ Warren, I think I might keep, because he might even be good just coming off the bench for 11 mil. I wouldn't mind that. Miles Turner definitely needs to be traded though. No offense to any big Miles Turner fans. He definitely is not shaping up to what I thought he would be at all, really. Okay, I might need to do a proposed trade, so I'll come back with you guys when I find a good center to replace Miles of Turner. Oh, okay, that worked. Alrighty, we got the trade for Clint Capella, a good defensive-minded center, which I think this team really needs. Sabonis isn't that great of at least a rim-protecting big, at least not in 2K. He only averages about 0.5 blocks, but I think Clint Capella would definitely help out with that, so I think that's a really good upgrade, especially since they are both paid the same amount of money. I think that's worth it, so we got a good center. And honestly, I think these guys are safe. I think as long as they improve, which I might just test the market right now just to see what we can get for Brogdon in a first pick, first round pick for a point guard. Because I really like having a core set for us with Dinwiddie. Dinwiddie's also 27. I want someone who will improve at least for next year, this next season. And then if we lose, I don't think I'm going to do another season. I might just try to do like a one-and-done season. So as far as we get this season is out. As far as we get, man, there's nothing really to get for Brock, and that's kind of sad, actually. And then we have our sixth man in Warren, so I'm going to try to get a small forward. You know what? Maybe I could even trade Malcolm Brogdon for a small forward and then sign a point guard, but I don't think there's any good backup point guards coming out. Okay, I think Dougie McBuckets I'm going to send off for 7 mil for a 28-year-old. I think that's kind of a lot. Nothing too crazy, though, to get, because we already have a pretty good setup of small forwards. Kyleev is going to back us up next year. I think he's going to improve a little bit more. He's already a 76. And then I need probably a better backup for Goga. Other than that, dude, this team is pretty set, honestly, for next year. We just need some improvement. So I'll come back with you guys after I get done with the draft, or if I trade for a draft pick. Okay, wow. So I just traded our first-round pick for next year and Aaron Holiday, and we were able to get the 8th pick in the draft, which is I thought wasn't going to be able to get us anything extremely good. But it seems like there were some couple of naughty picks before. Yeah, look at these. Oh my god, the Cavs. The Warriors. What are you guys doing? Well, they left us with Anthony Edwards, who is obviously one of the best pickups in the draft. Every time I've seen him, he's only 18 years old. 2'6'5". He's going to be like a Victor Oladipo coming off the bench. So I think I'm going to pick him up. Definitely. And then I'm going to see if I can get any trade offers for my boy Jeremy Lamb, because they're basically going to be the same type of player, both very offensive-minded shooting guards, or even the same height. So, but Anthony Edwards has a lot more, what are they called, badges. So, again, I will see you guys again if I make another move. So I just did another amazing trade. I just got Obi Toppin. I'll show you guys afterwards, but I literally just traded for Obi Toppin. We traded a future first and Goga, and there was a shooting guard we weren't using, and we got Obi Toppin. That's actually insane. Oh my god. I'll show you guys. Where's he at? I thought I just did. Right? Did I just not? I think I did. Not sure, but yeah, we got Obi. So now that we have Obi, Pacers are still paying off Monte Ellis' contract. That's crazy. I didn't even know that. I still wouldn't mind getting rid of my boy Malcolm Brogdon here, but there's no point guards I'm really wowed at. They have Kobe White they're willing to give up, but I'm trying to get like a win now type point guard. DeJounte Murray. Dude, DeJounte might be it. 15-8-6. I'm just really worried about Malcolm Brogdon's 3-point percentage. DeJounte might also be more of a potential player because he's younger. He might hit his potential higher. Oh my god, Lonzo. Yo, should I just get Lonzo just cuz? I'm gonna get Lonzo just cuz. I think that's just for me. Oh my god, Markel Fultz too. Yo, this is a lot. This is a lot coming really fast. Okay, let's see. We have Lonzo, Markel, and DeJounte Murray. Wow. You know what? I don't think I've ever traded for Lonzo Ball in one of my videos before. So, screw it. I'm just gonna do it. Why not? Welcome to the squad, Lonzo. Okay, so now we have some contracts to get rid of. We have this guy. Hey, Blazers, you can hold this real quick. Thank you. And we're going to get rid of Jake Lehman as well. Whoops, that was TJ Leaf. Jake Lehman. Hopefully I can trade him to like an Eastern rival. No, Atlanta. Oh, actually, how about Miami? You guys have bounced us out of the playoffs. You guys can hold this 7-0 for us, thank you. How we look at that? Okay, we're in the positive for salary cap. That's always good. And then we're looking at our roster right now. We have Lonzo, TJ McConnell. Then we have Victor Oladipo. We have Anthony Edwards. Then for small forwards, I'm going to see if I can sign a small forward to be a backup, maybe, or a starter. Get rid of Dougie McBuckets. For some power forwards, we have Sabonis and OB, and then trading TJ Leaf for a center. Wow, okay, I have a lot to work to do. And to make this video not so long, I will be back with you guys as soon as I make some. Okay, so I have this trade set up right now, and I don't know if I want to pull the trigger on it or not. Basically, I'm trading TJ Warren for Michael Porter Jr., who will be our starting small forward. I know I said I wanted to keep TJ off the bench, but there's no small forwards I could really sign for what we have in salary reasons and whatnot. So I know Michael Porter Jr. is going to be a great scorer. His per 36 is 20 points, 10 rebounds on 38% shooting from the three. TJ Warren has a little bit more of a resume. His per 36 stats are 20 points per game as well, but only getting 4 rebounds. Not his shooting as well. But, and on a much cheaper contract, but we had to take on Jeremy Grant, which I don't really want to do, so, for all the Pacers fans out there, I think I'm going to keep TJ Warren on the team, because he's also 26, he might develop a little bit more, actually, and development-wise, it would be nice, because I know Michael Porter Jr. is going to shoot up in ranking the next season, because he actually got some minutes played. You know what, I'm going to do this trade, I'm going to do it, why not? Yeah, that's fine, I'll do it. Alright, I'm just trying to base it off of his potential, and I think he will shoot up in potential this year because he actually got some playing time this year, so. So now we have Sabonis, well, let's go. Point guard, Lonzo, then we have Victor Oladipo. Michael Porter Jr. is going to make up for the lack of size of Victor Oladipo being only 6'4". Sabonis and Clint Capella, I really like this team. The team has a good mix of youth and age, good defense, good passing, with Sabonis and Lonzo Ball, good scoring, Michael Porter Jr. and Victor Oladipo, lockdown paint defender, then we have Anthony Edwards coming off the bench, with TJ McCollum, OJ Toppin, Jeremy Grant can be there if OB isn't doing so well. I like this team, I think I'm going to keep it. I might trade Doug McDermott, because no offense Doug McDermott, but you're just a great 3-point shooter. Perimeter defense is poo-poo, so I'm going to make a trade for you, and yeah, I guess I will see you guys with the finished team in the start of the end, well, the beginning of next season. Okay, I absolutely have to show you guys this because the Miami Heat are going to offer us the sniper, Duncan Robinson, and he's 6'7", he can definitely play the 3, great 3-point shooting, a scrappy player from what I've seen for playing games. Almost the 50-40-90 club in his second year in the league. I'm definitely taking him. Wow, that is a steal. Then we could just trade Jake Lehman again. Sorry, Jake. I love you. I have a picture with you from when we met. You're the man. I love you, but actually, I'm going to see if I can trade you to a Eastern team, the Bulls. I'm going to trade you back. Sign some scrubs and I need a center still. Crap. Okay, let me sign a center and I'll come back to you guys finally at the beginning of next season. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, we have the new roster for the new and improved Indiana Pacers, hopefully improved. But we have at point guard 84 overall Lonzo Ball, Victor Oladipo shot up back up to an 87 overall. We have Michael Porter Jr. at an 84 overall, just like Lonzo. Pretty great. We have Domantas Sabonis leading the team in overall. We also have Clint Capella down in the paint. We have Derek Favors coming off the bench. We have Anthony Edwards as well, T.J. McConnell, and Duncan Robinson. Obi Toppin being the backup four, with them switching between Jeremy Grant if Obi Toppin doesn't really quite make it. We also have a couple of filler guys down there, but yo, Lonzo, Oladipo, Michael Porter Jr., Sabonis, Clint Capella. In theory, there should be a good team, but I guess we're going to just have to look out for ourselves. So let's just show you guys. Simulator difficulty is at 50. And, we do have to do the classic. Cheese for team chemistry, just to help us out a little bit, because our team chemistry is severely lacking. Lacking right now. Actually, Derek Favors too, because Derek Favors doesn't really need to develop anything. And let's go do the trade deadline. Hopefully we won't have to make any trades, but I guess we'll just have to see that for ourselves. Obviously I'm going to be mostly afraid of the Milwaukee Bucks. I definitely probably should have gotten a better perimeter defender to go up against Giannis. I guess Michael Porter Jr., that could be your job, because you're about the same height as him, but definitely not going to be able to stop him that much. But we're doing pretty good so far. 4-1. 4-1. But, yeah. How are you guys doing? I'm doing fairly well. It's been a little bit of a struggle during these times right now, especially during work and things like that. So, I really much, very, very, very much appreciate you guys for sticking around during this time and still commenting and liking the videos and things like that. I really do appreciate it. I filmed an entire, like, 1 hour long video, but it took like 2 or 3 hours to record, and I had to edit a lot of it, but I didn't like how it turned out, so I trashed the video. So I'll have that video out for you guys later on during the week. Right now, I'm going to be filming, yes, this video. This video was supposed to come out yesterday, but again, like I said, the video I was working on before didn't turn out the way I liked it, so I scrapped it, decided to make this video. So I will be also posting a random gameplay video. If you have noticed a theme of games that I've been playing that aren't basketball or sports related, you will know what this game is. It's usually not too hard to figure out, but again, I really hope you're doing well during these times. I haven't really done a sit down chit chat video with you guys before, just being Jake and not being ASM baller. I think that's really important that I do another one of those at some point, because there are a lot of new people, new faces, new friends coming around this channel. We're almost at 2,500 subs, which is absolutely insane. Like I said before, I'm hoping by next February to hit 5k, so hopefully that that turns out to happen. But if not, then that's totally fine. But I think it'd be very, very, very nice. Alrighty. So as you can see, we are definitely doing a lot better than I thought we were going to do. Holy cow, my neighbor is being so loud right now, dude. It's literally 1 o'clock in the morning when I'm filming this video, and that's just super really best rate, Sabonis is up to a 90 overall. Holy cow. Averaging 16 points per game, 11.5 rebounds. A little bit down on his assists, but not too bad. We then have Victor Oladipo averaging back up to where he used to be before his injury. 22 points per game, 5 assists. That's awesome. Clint Capella goes up 1 overall. 14 points, 12 rebounds. Amazing. 1.5 blocks, basically. That's great. Lonzo Ball is up to 82 overall, averaging 16 points per game. 9 assists, almost 1.5 steals. Shooting percentages are all up. I put him in a camp, so that helps out a lot. Michael Porter Jr., again, I put him in one of the camps as well, and he shot up as well, shooting very, very, very well. Just everyone is doing so good. Wow, look at everyone. Y'all are making me so happy. Duncan Robinson only averaging 5 points per game. That's not too great. Obi is only getting 1 point. Why is that? I thought he was in the rotation, wasn't he? Oh, no, he's not. He was in the rotation. Oh, that's right, TJ McConnell. Okay, I totally forgot about that. He's doing 6 points, 6 assists. That's perfectly fine. 1 steal. Yeah, wow, this team is a lot better than I thought it was going to be. Oh, my goodness. Again, I don't think this team's going to win in the playoffs because we still have to go up against, you know, the Milwaukee Bucks and all that jazz. The Magic are third. That's pretty interesting. Did they get anybody? They got Derrick Jones Jr., RJ Hampton. That's about it. The Nets got everyone back, but they're not doing so hot. The Atlanta Hawks always do good. That second year, they always do a lot better. And out in the West, we got the Kings shooting up super high. Doesn't look like, well, they got Darren Collins, and that's about it. The Pelicans are in the playoff hunt as well, with Malcolm Brogdon there with them. They also have Rodney Hood, the Blazers. Get Evan Turner back on the squad. That's terrible. They also signed Isaiah Thomas. That'd be, oh god, I would hate that. But the Lakers are struggling a little bit to make a playoff spot. They did lose both Dwight and JaVale McGee to free agency, and only getting Mike Muscala out of it. That's not very good at all. And the Houston Rockets are the worst team in the West, second worst team in the NBA. Rockets third, tied for second in the NBA. That's totally insane. The Pistons are a team I'm definitely gonna have to do a rebuild on at some point, but I think I'm just gonna keep everything the way it is. I'm not gonna mess with anything at all. I just sort of hope that we can keep this going for the playoffs. Again, it's really great to always do what I do with the team chemistry thing. Make sure all of your bench warmers do team chemistry, so you build a really good team chemistry, and when your team chemistry is high, your players will develop faster and better and will play better together. So make sure you guys keep a lookout for that. But sorry, my neighbor is being so loud upstairs. You can hear him stomping around at literally, it's 1:02 in the morning right now. It's absolutely ridiculous, but it's whatever. But like I said before, I would really like to do another sit-down video with you guys. I wouldn't mind doing like a live stream at some point. I think that would be very, very, very fun. I would love to do a live stream, but I didn't know how I would even do it on my phone. I guess I would just film myself, or I can just film how I film gameplay videos, but I obviously don't have a computer to do a live stream off of, so I don't know how well the quality will be and all that jazz, but I think that'd be kind of fun. Wow, we are on a crazy win streak, dude. This is insane. Any crazy blowouts? We beat the Knicks by 30, we beat the Blazers by 40. Basically 40, that's crazy. Barely getting by the Spurs, though. The Spurs, who are another team. There are a lot of teams I need to do rebuilds for, but oh wow, we actually beat the Pelicans by 50. That's crazy. Gotta love them, the Pelicans, 50 points. Exactly, that's pretty crazy. Dang, we might actually have like an all-time team here. What the heck? I think I just might have built the perfect roster, maybe. I don't know. It might have been the perfect roster. Holy cow. Are we going to lose a game this season by the end? Oh my god. I need to show you guys again. Obviously, I haven't edited in a couple minutes or stopped filming in a minute. outside, maybe Denver. Oh my God. Yo, I need to look at that team. I need to look at that team. That team right there. The stats for that game. Oh my God, another almost 50 point blowout. Dude, what the heck? I am so surprised. Wait. Okay, Giannis wins MVP. LaMelo, rookie of the year. Sixth man of the year goes to DeMarcus Cousins. Anthony Davis. John Morant, most improved. Interesting. Nate McMillan, coach of the year. We're probably not going to get anyone on an all team, right? Yeah, we don't. That's kind of sad. I usually never do. But wow, let me look at this. Lonzo is just a killer, apparently, going from like an 80, like an 82 overall when we first got on the team, to like an 84 or 85 at the beginning of the season. Now he's at 87, developing super well. Capella did what he was supposed to do. Oh my god, he's at 88. He was like an 86 at the beginning of the season. Like I said, guys, dude, literally, like, team chemistry is such a big deal in this game. I might have to turn it off because I might be cheating the system a little bit, but... And then we also didn't have to go against Kawhi or LeBron in the finals. That's so lucky. Or even have to worry about Giannis or even KD. That's super lucky. Wow. Okay, guys, well, that's gonna be it for me. It looks like, I swear, we were going to not... Even that's why I said at the beginning of the video, I'm only gonna do one season because I didn't even think we were gonna be able to even make it to the finals, but we did, and we beat, and we swept the finals, so that's pretty crazy. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I will be posting a video, probably tomorrow's gonna be Thursday when you're watching this, so Friday I think I'll post a video, and then Sunday I'll post my basketball